welcome to another episode of the Africa Sports Report. I am your host, Leslie Koroma. And before we start, I just want to let you, the returning listeners to this program, as well as new listeners who are tuning in for the very first time, know that this podcast is now available on a variety of global platforms that ranges from iTunes to Spotify, iHeartRadio, and of course, the Google Play Music Store. You can find this podcast on those apps and the global, which means anywhere in the world you can listen to our podcast. And they're available from the brand new ones to the oldest ones that we've done in the past. So you can have a chance to go back and listen to some of the programs that we've done in the past. In this program, we bring you an in-depth analysis of the sports business in Africa. This program, this Africa Sports Report program, is an analytical program that is meant to provoke and stimulate development in the sports business across Africa. So this is why today's program is dedicated to specifically that particular aspect, the business of sports in Africa. Africa is underperforming on a variety of levels, given the scope of what we have available in Africa, the material, the content, the possibilities in terms of the large number of people who follow sports in Africa, that have a passion for sports in Africa. We are very much underperforming. So these are some of the issues we want to expand and look at today. We want to look at the business of sports in Africa with a special focus on sponsorship, the role of sponsorship in sports across the continent. I have a star-studded panel with me, individuals who I consider as well as many other people out there consider as thought leaders, people who are well up there in the sphere of this business, and they are go-to individuals, they're authorities, they're experts in this business, and these are the individuals I have with me on this on the panel today to talk about the business of sports in Africa. And I have Mr. Gary Rathbone, who used to be the head of Africa for Super Sports, as well as Mr. Themba Ntlawana, who is the founder and managing director for Sports Media Africa. Now, some of you who might know Gary will know a little bit about him, but I'll give you a little rundown about Mr. Rathbone. Gary is the founder of Sports News Africa, an endeavor to create new relevant sports programming for African broadcasters and advertisers looking to bring engaging sports content to viewers across the continent. He has been involved in African football as a journalist and a TV producer since the mid-90s. He has written, produced, and directed a host of African sports shows, including the Pan-African Football Show, the Africa Soccer Show, and Football Africa for Super Sports, and documentaries that have been broadcasted in over 30 African countries. He won the SAB South African Sports Journalist of the Year Award for Best TV Insert in 2006 for his piece on football, The Reconciliation in Rwanda, produced for his Football Africa show. Over the past 18 years, Gary has worked closely with a range of people connected to both sports and media across Africa, including the Confederation of African Football, CAF, with whom he worked to create and manage the CAF African Player of the Year Awards event between 2001 and 2005. In a move taking him from production to the business side of African sports media, he was appointed the first head of Africa for Super Sports in 2008, where he was responsible for managing all aspects of the network's business in sports and broadcasting outside of South Africa. Here, he worked to develop the potential of local sports, including the Kenyan, Nigerian, Ghanaian, Ugandan, Angolan and Zambian football leagues, helping them become an attractive and exciting proposition to fans, the media, and sponsors in their own countries and beyond. He resigned in 2012 to focus on Sports News Africa, a project that he founded himself. That's drawn back into the business of African sports media as head of sports for East African broadcaster Zuku between 2013 and 2014. From there, he was appointed as the director of sports for Chinese African broadcaster Star Times for 2014 and 15, developing and launching five new sports channels for the broadcaster in 2015. More recently, he has worked as a consultant on African sports and media for the Discovery Channel. He is currently working in partnerships with African channel builder Africa XP to develop and launch a new sports channel, Sports Connect. Over and above this, in 2017, he also consulted and advised on sports media rights for Nigerian broadcaster Minaj, an investment group TPG, in an investment in the Zampay TV network in Tanzania, as well as global sports right enterprise B4 Advisory. Now that's quite a mouthful for Gary. So you could tell he's very well experienced in this business. He's well established and the word is beyond well, you know. So that's Gary Ratbone for you. Now let's take a look at Mr. Themba Lawana. Themba is the founder and managing director of Sports Media Africa. He has more than a decade of experience in sports rights distribution and commercial exploitation. SMA is primarily involved with the Pan-African distribution of sports rights content and has a diversity of clients such as pay TV, FTA, OTT, telcos, etc. It has established strong relationship with Sports Media Africa. It has established strong relationship with global content suppliers and rights holders. Sports Media Africa also works with various African sports federations to assist them enhance the capabilities of commercializing media assets and rights. Sports Media Africa recognizes that the ultimate opportunity in African sports media is in local sports content and programs. It has now positioned itself to create projects and partnerships to develop and produce world-class African sports content. Themba also co-produced the African Sports TV Market Report, which is a comprehensive analysis of the industry and is currently working on the next edition of that report. So you can see how extensive the experiences of the these two gentlemen that I have on this program with me today go, how far they range. Now that I've given you kind of whetted your appetite for what's to come in this program, I would like to take you to our usual roundup of sports scores for the weekend, and then we'll proceed on to bring you the interviews. I want you to stay tuned because this is a really interesting program, very educative, very informative. It's something that's really critical for the development and growth of sports in Africa. So, that being said, let me go ahead and start off with my usual, which is English Premier League. In the English Premier League, it was Brighton over the Wolves 1-0. Southampton in Newcastle played to a draw 0-0. Liverpool over Cardiff City 4-1. And it was Watford over Huddersfield, 3-0. Bournemouth over Fulham, 3-0. Leicester City and West Ham played to a draw, 1-1. Chelsea over Burnley FC, 4-0. Crystal Palace and Arsenal played to a draw, 2-2. And it was Manchester United over Everton, 2-1. Last game for the weekend, which will be on Monday, will be between Tottenham and Manchester City. Now let's move over to United States in the Major League Soccer. In Major League Soccer, the scores were Sporting Kansas City 2, LAFC 1, New England Revolution 1, Montreal Impact 0, Colorado 2, FC Dallas 1, Houston Dynamo 3, LA Galaxy 2, Seattle Sounders 2, San Jose 1, New York City FC 3, Philadelphia 1, Toronto FC 4, Atlanta United 1, Chicago and DC United played to draw 0-0, Columbus 3, Minnesota United 2, New York Red Bulls 1, Orlando City 0, and Vancouver 2, Portland 1. And that was a roundup of the Major League Soccer scores in the United States. Let's take a look at what happened in the German Bundesliga. It was SC Freiburg over Mönchengladbach, 3-1. Bayern over Mainz, 2-1. Wolfsburg over Fortuna, 3-0. Hertha and Dortmund played to draw 2-2. FC Augsburg over Hannover 96, 2-1. Hoffenheim over VfB Stuttgart, 4-0. Nuremberg and Eintracht played 2, a 1-1 draw. We had Leipzig and Schalke, 0-4, 0-0. Bayer and Werder, 6-2. The World Series is complete in baseball. Like I said last week, I was going to bring you scores in Major League Baseball in the United States. The playoffs were on, and it's now concluded. The Boston Red Sox are the world champions of the world. They won the World Series, beaten the LA Dodgers 5-1 in the fifth game. They won the game, sixth game. So. Fifth game. I'm sorry again. Yeah, that was out of a seven game series. They won the series in five after running through the Houston Astros as well. Now let's go on and talk a little bit about. Let's look at the NFL scores for this weekend. On Thursday night, it was the Houston Texans over the Miami Dolphins, 42-23. And then this weekend, today's Sunday, it was the Jacksonville Jaguars falling down to the Philadelphia Eagles in London, 24-18. The Carolina Panthers, 36 over the Baltimore Ravens, 21. The Kansas City Chiefs, who are standing 7-1 right now with their record, a very good record, over the Broncos, 30-23. Pittsburgh Steelers, 33 over the Cleveland Browns, 18. The Seattle Seahawks, 28 over the Detroit Lions, 14. Cincinnati Bengals, 37 over the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, 34. It was the Chicago Bears, 24 over the New York Jets, 10. Washington Redskins, 20 over the New York Giants, 13. Indianapolis Colts, 42 over the Oakland Raiders, 28. The Arizona Cardinals, 18 over the San Francisco 49ers, 15. The LA Rams, 29 still undefeated over the Green Bay Packers, 27. And then it was the New Orleans Saints, 30 over the Minnesota Vikings, 20. The Monday night game will be between the New England Patriots and the Buffalo Bills. In the NBA, we are going to look at just the weekend scores, which is yesterday's, Saturday's, and today's scores, Sunday's. So we have the New Orleans the Pelicans falling to the Utah Jazz, 132-111. It was the Celtics, 109 over the Pistons, 89. The 76ers, 105 over the Hornets, 103. It was the Chicago Bulls, 97 over the Atlanta Hawks, 85. Indiana Pacers, 119 over the winless Cavaliers, Cleveland Cavaliers, 107. As the Miami Heat, 120 over the Portland Trail Blazers, 111. The Grizzlies, 117 over the Phoenix Suns, 96. It was the Milwaukee Bucks, 113 over the Orlando Magic, 91. And it was the San Antonio Spurs, 110 over the LA Lakers, 106. In today's games, we had the Warriors, 120 over the New Jersey Nets, 114 or Brooklyn Nets. Once again, I keep messing up with these names because this is how far.